Good morning, my children.
Good morning, Dad.
We are so excited to be here. Let's welcome our friends to another Connected Kids. Woo! This is Connected Church. The Connected Kids is the children's church of the Connected Kids Church. This is our Sunday morning children's church service. Can you say good morning, Ariella?
Good morning, Daddy.
Can you say good morning, Daniel?
Good morning, Daddy.
Happy Sunday, everybody. My name is Charles Botts. I am the founder of Connected Church here, and I'm excited to be with you one more time for another children's church. We are going to jump right into it. Ariella, would you be willing to please, nice and loud, open us up with our prayer?
Okay. Lord, help us have a good children's church that we listen to, Daddy, and have fun. And have a good time and listen. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. And we're going to jump right into it. Our morning worship song is Let the Walls Fall Down by Maranatha Kids. We're just going to be playing the audio today. So here we go.
Let the
morning
to dance when it's like this.
One by one, we're drawn together.
Awesome job. Well done, guys. Great way to start off service. Thank you so much. So, we are going to do something a little different today. We've done it before,
we are going to actually have Ariella read our Bible story this morning. So we've got two different versions that we're going to read. The first version you guys have seen before. We've shown this to you. This is our the beginner's Bible. That's the first version that we're going to read. So, Ariella, I'm going to ask you to please read the story of John baptizes Jesus.
John was born just before Jesus was. They were cousins. When John grew up, he lived in the desert and ate bugs and honey. John told the people about God. They asked him many questions about what is right and what is wrong. John told them to be good and kind and honest. John preached about God's forgiveness. Many people decided to follow God. John baptized the people in a river.
I was fixing the bookmark.
John told the people to get ready for a special person who could save them from their sins. One day, Jesus came to the river. John knew Jesus was a special person. Jesus told him, "I need to be baptized by you." John was surprised. But Jesus said, "It is right for you to do this." So John took Jesus into the Jordan River and baptized him. The Holy Spirit came down from the heaven in the form of a dove. It landed on Jesus. Jesus smiled. And God said, "This is my son, and I will love him, and I love him. I am very pleased with him."
Perfect. Thank you, Ariella. You can close that up. And so then the other version that we're going to read, Daddy's going to read, is our question Bible. I don't remember actually where we got this, but it was given to us somewhere. It's 365 Bible stories, so a different Bible story each year and each day of the year. And at the bottom, I don't know if you can see that, so there's the story and then there are some questions. So it's a great way to gauge retention.
Excuse me.
So this is John baptizes Jesus. "I wonder if he's Christ. Everyone wondered about John the Baptist. I baptize you with water," he answered. "The one who's coming is greater than I am. He'll baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire." John was speaking of Jesus. Jesus came to be baptized by John, but John said, "You should baptize me." "It's proper for us to do this," Jesus answered. "We'll be doing what's right." John baptized Jesus. Just then, God's Spirit came down like a dove, and God spoke. We heard Ariella just read this too. "This is my son whom I love. He pleases me." So a couple questions, guys. Question number one, what happened when Jesus was baptized?
The heaven came down in the form of a dove.
Daniel, what did God say about Jesus?
"This is my son, and I am pleased with him."
Very good. "This is my son, and I am pleased by him." Very good. "I'm pleased with what he does." Very good. Both of you, very good. Yes, Ariel.
I was just going to say, I think we got that from my night nurse.
Oh, maybe. Yeah, very possible. I don't think he actually gave that. He gave you a different Bible. But at any rate, so Jesus gets baptized by John, and one of the most memorable parts of Jesus getting baptized by John is not just the fact that Jesus got baptized, which was a big deal, but it was also because when Jesus was baptized, something really special happened. Daniel, you just told us, what happened when Jesus got baptized?
The Holy Spirit came in the form of a dove.
And what did we hear? What happened?
It came down like fire.
No, you were right the first time. It came down like a form of a dove, but we heard something. Or the people that were there heard something when Jesus was baptized. You just told us.
It's hard for me to remember because that was...
But you just told us. What did they hear when Jesus was baptized? They heard...
This is my son, and I'm pleased with him.
Who said that?
Jesus. I mean God.
Yes, yeah. Which I know it's kind of tricky because Jesus is God, and so Jesus was being baptized, but then they heard God's voice, but Jesus is God. And I know, that's kind of tricky, and I think...
Yeah, because God's... Because there's one God, but these men have three parts. So I think one part. So I think there's three gods, because there's three parts of Jesus. So I think it's like.
But there's only one.
Yes.
Yeah, that's very, very important to remember that there's only one. That God may present as God that created everything, and Jesus that lived among us and taught us how to live. And the Holy Spirit that lives in us right now. But there's not three. It's one God that has these three different roles. Three different roles to God's relationship with creation. So Jesus comes up out of the water, and we hear God say, "This is my son. I love him. I am pleased by him." What pleased God? What do you think pleased God, Ariella?
He followed Jesus and...
Who followed Jesus?
His son. Wait, no, his son. Oh. He was pleased by him because he got baptized?
Yeah. God was pleased with Jesus because Jesus got baptized. Remember, when Jesus was going to get baptized by John, what did John say? What was John's first reaction?
Jesus should be baptizing John.
Yeah. John was like, "Wait a minute. I know who you are. I think you're the Christ. You're the one that I've been preaching about. You should be baptizing me."
Not me, but not the other way around.
And what did Jesus say?
This is right.
This is what should happen. It should happen this way. And so Jesus gets baptized, and we hear God say, "This is my beloved son. He pleases me with what he's done." That getting baptized was right. And so Jesus shows us an example of one way to please God. So what's one way that we could please God? Oh,
Getting baptized.
And I have multiples in one.
Okay.
My first one of the multiples is being baptized. Next one, praying to God, talking to God, and reading our Bible.
Yep, excellent. So, getting baptized pleases God. Here's the interesting thing. John was baptizing people a special way. Do you guys remember what John was baptizing people for? Ella, do you remember what John was baptizing people for?
To get ready and clear their hearts so that way they could go up to heaven.
To help clear their hearts to get ready. There was a specific word that John was using when he was baptizing people. He begins with an R. He was baptizing them into
rejoiced.
Repentance. John was baptizing people into repentance, which means he was baptizing them so that they would have a change of mind. They would turn away from the life that they were living, where they were focused on their own efforts, and they were focused on their own way of doing things, and they were going to turn and go in the direction that God wanted them to go into and follow God's word and do what God was saying. So John was baptizing people into repentance. Now Jesus didn't need to repent because Jesus was doing what God wanted to do from the very beginning. So there's something very unique and very special about why Jesus was baptized. Yes, Daniel, do you think you know?
Yes, I think I know. What was it again? Okay, I can't remember what I was going to say.
Jesus was baptized so that he would be pure for his ministry. Because up until this point, Jesus hadn't really started preaching, like publicly preaching on a regular basis. And so he was baptized, sit up please, he was baptized so that he could do his work, and he could do it being spiritually clean. Mm-hmm. He didn't get baptized to wash his body, because that's not how you wash your body. He got baptized so that his heart and his spirit would, his heart and his soul would be clean and would be pure, so that when he ministered, God would be pleased with his ministry.
Mm.
Does that make sense?
Of course.
Okay, so we're going to do our craft, and our craft is going to represent, it's going to symbolize God's spirit descending or coming down onto Jesus. So we're going to do something kind of fun. Let me share my screen for our friends who may be watching and following along. Again, we're getting our lesson from sundayschool.works. And today's craft is actually, and this is kind of old school for my parents like me that grew up in the 80s and 90s. We're doing some tie-dye today. We're doing a little bit of tie-dye. So what you're going to do is, if you have coffee filters, that's great. We did not have coffee filters, so I ended up just cutting some paper towel, and I tried it out. It works really well. And so your children are going to make designs on their paper towel. And when they finish with their design, or their coffee filters, what have you, when they're finished with their design, you're going to spray the filter or the paper towel with a little bit of water. You're not trying to drench it. You want it wet, but you don't want it dripping wet. So you're going to spray it with the water and then let it dry. And then you can use a pipe cleaner. You can use some ring or some stribbin, string or some ribbon. And you're going to attach the balloon to the coffee filter, and you can write a scripture on the balloon for this project representing a God's spirit. I did one a little earlier. Let me show you how it came out.
Ooh, that looks nice.
It's not fully dry. But this has been sitting for probably about 10 minutes. And so, I mean, you can see the paper towel. So, you know, it's paper towel. It's fairly absorbent. But you can see the tie-dye effect that's happening. So with that, we're going to get Ariella and Daniel set up. We'll get them working on their craft. And then we will come back to wrap up. Okay, so as you guys can see, Ariella and Daniel are finishing up, which is great. And so as we come to the end of another Connected Kids, just a couple things and by way of review, very important to point out, Jesus was obedient. Jesus was obedient, even though Jesus is the Son of God. He came to the earth and came without sin. Jesus was still obedient and was baptized. And it was the fact that Jesus followed through on what he was supposed to do that made his father so pleased, that made his father so proud. And notice what God did. God immediately provided his son with some positive feedback when he was baptized. So parents, so important that we reinforce positive lessons when our children are following through, when our children are being obedient, when our children do praiseworthy things, that we don't hold those praises back from them, that we don't hold those compliments back from them. Jesus gets baptized, he comes out of the water, the Holy Spirit comes down in the form of a dove, and God's voice is audibly heard. This is my beloved son. I am pleased with him. I am pleased with what he's done. So important that we don't hold those compliments back, that we share those. And chief among them, baptism. Baptism is important. Baptism is a real thing. It's important to be baptized at an age of accountability, an age where you can understand that you are following through on God's plan for your life. Baptism is a way to take your relationship with God, to take your relationship with Jesus to that next level. It is very important and something that we'll be talking about more in the coming weeks and months. And so with that, we are want to thank you once again for spending some of your Sunday with us here at Connected Kids, the Children's Church Ministry of Connected Church. Ariella, do you have anything that you want to share, say, before we close out today?
No, thank you.
Daniel, do you have anything you want to share or say before we close out?
I'm just going to finish this part of what... Yes. Okay. What I want to say is that I hope that everybody who's been with us today, all of our Sunday work, stays safe, stays healthy, and stay in this fight, and everybody in the world is healthy, safe, and will stay in this fight of COVID.
Awesome. Thank you, Daniel, and thank you, Ella. Daniel started to say it, but we'll say it one more time. Officially for the record, stay safe,
stay healthy,
and
stay
in the fight. All right. God bless everyone. Take care. Bye-bye. We'll see you again soon.
Bye,
Ella. Bye, Daniel.
Oh,
nice job with your pinwheel.
Yes.